mentioned a couple of things that I would like to pick up on. The first is how you got the lab equipment to Butembo. Now, I imagine this was particularly difficult because of the various issues that you've been faced with, let's say COVID, Ebola, and you, of course, politically, it's quite a charged atmosphere in Congo with the terror and the rebels. Mm. How did you get the lab equipment to Butembo? Or did you face many challenges in that regard?
You know, it was more difficult because the one of the partners of Ricolto ordered at the same time the same equipment from Brazzafrica, Kigali, and then the equipment went to Idjwi, an island which is near Goma, and then from then it has been shipped on the boat up to Goma, and from Goma we took our own car to bring the equipment to Butembo. It was a long way, going from Kigali to Idjwi Island, from Idjwi Island to Goma, and then from Goma to Butembo.
But if I can ask you this more personal question, us Europeans, we are aware of the issues that the Congo is facing, and that it's, the government advises us not to travel to, especially East Congo. When you are traveling around, getting the lab equipment, ordering stuff, and you've recently been traveling, are you still afraid that something might happen, or have you gotten used to living with it?
Yeah, I mean, we are not so afraid because, even the context of insecurity, the people who face that situation, they can relativize some cases, and by finding maybe some zones which seem green compared to other which are really red. And then we have those signals from security officers or the MONUSCO, the UN mission guy, so they can say, no, don't go to that village because maybe there might be security issues. We know that, and from Butembo, from Goma to Butembo, there is a military escort. All travelers are really before they cast and in the middle, and the end of the queen. There are militaries who take care of the whole escort, and this is done twice a day. This is a security guarantee. And once we meet the escort, then we are somehow sure that we will attain our final destination. But however, there are other zones where really the situation is not stable, and then we really have to cancel our travel to on that access, like currently Butembo to Ituri is not possible on roads.
How many people do you usually travel with then? How many people accompany you and guide you?
Sorry, come again, please. In a report.
How many people do you travel with when you go on these long routes to get the lab equipment, for example?
Yeah, that's what we were. Well, no, only four people, in our car. But there are other cars which are owned by private guys, and we will have a long line of cars, maybe a long line, by rounds, they can easily reach 3,300 people, not